Tell us about your athlete who was number four at Dubai.
Yes, Jonathan Mayo. He's living here.
Oh, he's living right here. Yeah.
He is practically the balance of Abel.
The balance.
Yes. So Abel is so explosive, extrovert. Mm-hmm. Not practically. Jonathan is the one using more the brain, more. Is able to think more, no, to be more tranquil.
Yeah.
And when we started in April, because I started in April only with Abo and with Jonathan. Jonathan was come from 62:28 in a half marathon. Mm-hmm. Had a problem in the knee, and I discussed with them to change a completely type of approach, also mental, not everything. And he was already second in half marathon after staying with the Abel for all the preparation for World Championships.
Mm-hmm. No?
And after this, we went to the Great North Run. Mm-hmm. He was a second behind Matati. Mm-hmm. No? And in 59:27. Mm-hmm. And after we planned there already to go to Dubai.
Right. So when he ran 59:27, you knew he could run very fast in the marathon.
My goal was to run about 2:06 for him.
And then he runs under 2:05, yeah?
Yeah, but the conditions were perfect. Dubai was like Berlin, same thing. Dubai or Berlin this year is the same thing. Mm. Nothing changed.
So if how can you compare his fitness to Abel?
2 minutes of difference.
2 minutes.
When they are completely okay, 2 minutes. And this, in fact, is something that also to on the mind of Abo, something like this can create again a difference, no?
Yeah.
Because
he knows he's 2 minutes
he
faster.
That, if he's a complete in shape in the same condition,
right,
it's difficult to find this condition.
Right.
Where in condition, I tell you, in Berlin, we are conditioned in Dubai, no, we are conditioned in Frankfurt, but we are not, for example, conditioned in Chicago.
Right.
No?
Yeah.
So it depends. And but if you find this condition, it's possible for an athlete like Abo running maybe under 2:03 also.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, the case of Abu is a particular case because he is good image because 2 times a world champion is important.
Mm-hmm.
But in the ambience of the athletes is a little bit underrated.
Yeah, because he's only had 2:05.
Never won a major or something like this.
Yes, yes.
So 100% in the mind of the other winner, no, he is weaker, also if he's the world champion.
Yeah.
And I tell you that I probably can give some surprise in London.
Yeah.
Because the possibility, last year won world champion with 17 days off in the last 2 months for injury, for something like this.
Mm.
So practically in all August we had five sessions only.
So Abel had all that time off before World Championships in Daegu, you're saying?
He had an injury before.
And he still wins. Before. Yeah.
I had the doubt if call Athletic Kenya telling cancel Abel. Mm-hmm. I sit with him and I told Abel to do something that is we in Italian, you know, in English, but in Italian we tell no carne, no pesce, no meat, no fish.
Mm.
So something that is nothing. Mm. It's useless. You are the defending champion. Or you go for winning or you stay home.
Yeah.
There is nothing else. No? So we needed to find a solution for this, going to high specificism and after long recovery, no, also for the knee.
Yeah. Can you tell me
the situation worked?
Yeah, yeah. Can you tell me a little about Moses? Because Moses trains in another group, yeah?
Yes,
yeah.
Moses, no group, and he's alone, because the other...
Oh, he's alone.
Gio was with us last time for a special block Monday, no?
Mm-hmm.
And really, he understood what is the difference. Something that only him can do. He went for 30 kilometers in the morning, 1 hour 36:27, and 15 in the afternoon, 46:32. No, 52 kilometers in the day with a wind that was terrible wind. You can ask because he was on the pickup.
And he's at altitude. At 10,000 feet.
Yes, and after, but it's not a problem altitude, but it was very hot because Nairobi is more hot than here in the Gong.
Mm-hmm.
And after 3 kilometers, he was alone. So starting with a big group. No. 3 kilometers, all the other. So, but you know, for preparing marathon, sometimes can be also something good because in marathon, if you want to beat a record or if you want, you need to be able to be alone.
Yeah,
it's not something for everybody.
And you're sending him to Rotterdam?
Rotterdam.
Yeah.
Rotterdam. Also Sami Kitvara is in Rotterdam and also Peter Kirui.
Mm.
I think that it can become really, depend on the conditions.
Yeah.
But the condition very, very important. with this type of attitude, with the type of pace that we want, 61:20 at half marathon,
yeah.
No, the pace for 32 kilometers is the Geoffrey Kipsang, mm-hmm. that can become in 3 years the new world record holder of marathon, mm. is the world junior champion of cross.
I see.
And already is able to run 32, 35 kilometers at the pace of 2 or 3
uh-huh.
now. So he,
so he will be the pacer.
Yes, yeah. He paced 32, and after I am happy that there is competition with Sammy, with Peter Kirui, mm-hmm. because also who is not the winner run under 204, mm. if the condition is normal. Mm. No. So really when I say that the marathon, the world of marathon can change, mm-hmm. I think that people suppose that I am optimistic. No, instead the reality, I tell you, that can overtake the more optimistic previous.
Mm.
I am not surprised if at the end of this year we have more than 10 athletes under 204,
mm-hmm.
and maybe 3 under 203.
Mm-hmm.
No, it's mm-hmm. possible, 100% mm-hmm. of these people. No? Mentality changed, also the interpretation of the race. No? There is no race where the with pace, where the pace is not 62, 62:10 at the beginning, and using the negative split, so automatically you yeah. go under 204.
Mm-hmm.
So this is what happened.
The Ethiopians, like for example, can there be 3 Ethiopians under 203? Or is it, or are the strongest the Kenyans?
In Dubai, we speak about Jonathan.
Yeah, yeah.
The second Ethiopian is my athlete, no? Because I have Ethiopian
uh-huh,
also.
Uh-huh.
And he came from 2:10:33 and ran 2:04:50.
Yeah.
Dino Sefio. And the athlete is not as strong like the Ayele. Ayele has a very big potentiality.
Mm-hmm.
Because the last 2,200 meters was something incredible, no? Mm. He ran practically about 6 or 7, mm. no, there.
Mm.
And But globally, I had, for example, 4 Ethiopians. This is funny because I prepare a program for a group of Ethiopians. I never knew one of them that I don't know. So, the athletes were the same before.
Mm-hmm.
The local coach, Gemedu Degefu, is called, was the same before. The athletes had already from 3 to 6 marathon in their palmarès,
mm-hmm.
and the personal best were 2:10, 2:09:50, mm-hmm. practically something like this. No?
And so everybody, you're taking them from 2:10, 2:09 to 2:04.
1:13 around 2:06, 2:17.
Yeah.
All. No, I gave the program. No, we use it today, and mm-hmm. also we change it also with the group of Global, mm-hmm. because Global now with me and Getane, that is the coach of Kebede, also changed something.
Mm-hmm.
So globally we have 17 athletes in top 10 between men and women, mm-hmm. no, in top 20,
mm-hmm.
so, here and there.
Mm-hmm.
So really something, when we speak about the system changing, this is the demonstration. Mm-hmm. Because we speak about Jonathan, maybe also that is also something from myself, speaking with them, I stay many times with them, change the mind.
Mm.
But with Ethiopians that I didn't know. I knew the first time there in Dubai.
Mm.
No, for the first time.
Mm.
No, and only I teach to the coach how to,
yeah.
I don't know, to grow in feeling
mm-hmm.
with the artists from outside.
Mm-hmm.
And how to teach to the artists how mm-hmm. they could grow in their feeling mm-hmm. with the workouts.
Mm-hmm.
No, so we were in touch continuously by phone for yeah. people that I didn't know and yeah. average.
Yeah.
As Lef Merja, practically, no, 3 minutes so, at yeah. this level, everybody.
So at this point, it's not just technical training. It's like a wisdom of understanding the athletes.
I think that
the
point is really this one.
Yeah.
So the main point, after you can do something else. No, the specific of a marathon is running at about a marathon pace, long, very long.
Uh-huh.
And because this is very, very expensive, no,
mm-hmm.
and you need to recover very long. Finish.
Mm-hmm.
Finish. The what you see today is like a marathon at sea level, about 2:10 to 2:11,
mm-hmm.
and this is in training.
Yeah.
No, so it's something for people, something astonishing.
Yeah.
But if you look for 2:04 mm-hmm. and you run a full marathon in 6 or 7 minutes slower, this is specific training.
Yeah.
It's not something strange, no.
Yeah, yeah.
For people.
Yeah.
So the intensity is the specific intensity is what we need.
Mm-hmm.
The intensity without the specific, without distance, is useless.
Mm-hmm.
And this, sorry, is the American system, or is the system of UK.
Mm-hmm.
Yesterday I went for 2 athletes in UK. I'm not able, 28:30 in 10,000 meters, I'm not able to have a training like the ladies here.
Mm-hmm.
So there is not idea about what is marathon.
Mm-hmm.
This is very simple.
Mm-hmm.
No. So it's not, so a marathon is not running a lot of kilometers slowly, and put a lot of speed short.
Mm-hmm.
This could be, which is the difference, for example, in the United States of 40 years ago.
Mm-hmm.
40 years ago, with Lydiard, no, the idea of Lydiard, they ran a lot of kilometers slow. Okay,
mm-hmm.
but mm-hmm. they have a lot of competition, all.
Yeah.
So, Frank Short, Bill Rogers, all of these people, mm-hmm. they have a lot of competition. So the intensity was in the race.
Yeah.
And the extension was easy, mm-hmm. practically, mm-hmm. but there was intensity. Mm-hmm. After this, because there were no marathons, mm-hmm. after this marathon became a big business, and becoming a big business, no, also for the coaches become something to coach in an exclusive way, mm-hmm. and remaining the idea of the long run, something like this, but because there were no other competition in the middle, disappeared the idea of the intensity, because the intensity before was because of the competition.
Yeah, yeah.
So
yeah.
we went in a
so
period.
So now they're not racing as much, and they're running a lot of middle
so,
pace. Yeah.
So Paula Radcliffe was the first practically changing this mentality, but not looking for marathon, because she didn't understand what she did. But because in 2002, she had, after running the marathon in London, two very important goals on the track, mm-hmm. 5,000 meters in Commonwealth mm-hmm. and 10,000 meters in European. Mm-hmm. So she continued to have the type of training for 10,000 meters, mm-hmm. no?
Yeah.
supported by the long distance that she did.
Yes.
And so, this was the reason because she ran 2:15.
Yeah, so I have a question. So Radcliffe runs very fast in her career. She ran very fast on her easy days. Every day she goes out and runs fast. Mm-hmm. Do your athletes on their... So tomorrow, will Abel run very slow?
No, very slow.
Very slow, yeah?
The next workout is Thursday.
Yeah, so it's Saturday, so he will run pretty slow,
yes.
and then he'll run intense again.
Yes,
yeah.
yes. I believe very much in top modulation,
mm-hmm.
big modulation.
Yeah.
So the reason is more slow, but slow attention. We speak about the last 2 months. Or preparation, because before you needed to create a base,
yes, yes,
and when you create the base, there is not top modulation.
Right,
but
right.
When
so you create the base by running
yes,
solid every day.
In the specific,
yeah.
you need. So when you squeeze everything, we go to kill the quality. Instead, for every event, no, you are in shape and you can able to reach the top results and to peak mm-hmm. when you are able to support your top quality, not to kill the quality.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So squeezing, no, yeah. like for example, there is in UK how no that these guys here mm-hmm. work very tough every day.
Yeah.
Maybe that I have a reason. I don't know, but I don't agree.
Right.
For me, it's exactly the opposite.
Mm-hmm.
Exactly the opposite.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Top quality and long rest in the middle.
Go ahead.
Have you done? Renato, con la giornalista delle...